Hello friends, so today we'll learn about the another topic from the genetic engineering and course RBT 501 and from 5th semester unit 5 cell signaling. I am Dr. Deepak Gola, assistant professor in the department of biotechnology at Noida Institute of Engineering and Technology, Greater Noida. So we will start from the first slide, that is what is cell signaling. Cell signaling is simple, when we signal something, the person will react. Like we have a red light signal. So we have a red light, yellow light, orange light, and the green light. So in red light we stop, in green light we go. So here also there are some molecules will help in the communication of the cell, because the cell also require the communication in between them for the proper functioning of the various biochemical processes in our life. So here is the cartoon which is depicting the cell signaling processes. This is the receptor, this is the ligand which is present on the cell membrane. This is ligand, this is ligand, which is also called a signal molecule, and this is a receptor which will bind. This is receptor which is bind to the ligand. So here how the cell will communicate, we will learn in the detail. First of all, the introduction. What is cell signaling? Cell signaling is a biological mechanism that occur in the cell which give a cell an ability to receive or generate a signal in response to the surrounding environment. And the another is the cell to cell communication between the cell is mediated by extracellular signal molecule, some from the external environment. Some of those operate over a very long distance, and other signal may operate at a very to the neighboring cell. For example, if this is the cell, so it should also have a different kind of cell around it, so they will signal or they will work in harmony for the proper functioning of the body. So they will receive some signals from the surrounding, and they will also produce some signal for the surrounding. So this is how the cell will communicate around the with the different cell for the normal life processes. So these are the some definition which is required we have to learn for the to understand the signal processing. So cell signaling processing, the first is the signaling. What is signaling? Cell will cell communicate with the cell, other cell communication of in between which is lie in to the nearby or from the distance. The second is cell transduction. Cell transduction is a process in which the signal molecule will bind to the receptor, and receptor will generate the intracellular mechanism inside the cell in response to that signal. The next is ligand. The ligand will act as a signaling molecule for the receptor which is present on the cell membrane. The next is the receptor. Receptor will bind to the specific ligand and transmit this signal to the intracellular molecule or targets, and which later led to the different receptor, and different receptor can bind to the different ligands. Different receptor can respond differently to the same ligand. So this is the process how it occurs. So first of all, we have the receptor here, and if there is a signal molecule which bind, let it be the signal molecule or ligand, it will bind to this receptor, and it will affect the various membrane protein. For example, in this case, this is a G protein, and this effector molecule will stimulate the signal further intracellularly. So it will affect the various processes like transcription, communication, translation of various proteins for the normal functioning of the life. So, first definition is the cell signaling. It is about the communication between different group of cell and tissues, and how one group of a cell inform another group of cell what to do next. The signal transduction. It referred how the presence of an extracellular molecule can produce a change in the intracellular state of a cell without the initial signal crossing the membrane. So, in this the signal molecule will not cross the membrane, and it will affect the receptor. It will change the configuration of the receptor, which led to the further transmission of the signal inside the cell. So, why do cell require to communicate? First of all, during the development of the cell or cell differentiation to adopt the specialized role. Second, cell need to know whether he has to live, die or divide at some point of time. Next is neurotransmission. In this, neuron will communicate. If someone pinch you, it will create a signal and it will transmit to the brain, and brain cell will amplify and will respond again that pinch, and this is how the signal molecule work. And next is the regulation of metabolism. Metabolism is of two type, you know, catabolism and anabolism. In catabolism, the it is anabolism and this is catabolism. In anabolism, simple molecule will give a complex molecule, and in this complex molecule will degrade to the simpler form, to the simple form. And next is during contraction and expansion of our muscle cells, and next is the secondary sexual characteristics. So, there are various mode how cell will communicate with the other cell. First of all is the signaling by cytoplasmic bridge. So, in this case what happen, one cell will form a cytoplasmic bridge with the another cell and will transform the signal from this cell to this. So, it is a forming a cytoplasmic bridge by dissolving that membrane, and signal molecule will move from the first cell to the second cell. This is how the signal will transfer with the from the cytoplasm. So, this is bridge of cytoplasm, hence it is called a cytoplasmic bridge. The next is the by releasing a signal molecule. In this case what happen, a cell will release a signal molecule, let it be the signaling cell. It release a molecule, this black color is a molecule, it release this signal, and there are specialized cell, there are target cell for this signal molecule, and this signal molecule will bind to these receptor which are specific to those signals. So, this circular black part will bind to this gap and it will cause the conformation change. It will affect the another protein and the effector protein, which will transduct signal intercellularly and will respond accordingly. This type of signal molecule when a cell release a signal molecule and it will bind to the another target cell with the help of receptor, this is called signaling by secreted molecule. The third one is the signaling by plasma membrane bound molecule. In this case what happened, the signal molecule itself present on the cell, the signal molecule is present itself on the cell, and like the receptor which is present on the cell. So, this signal molecule will bind to this receptor which is present on the cell, and they both will communicate with each other. So, there are different intercellular signal is subdivided into the following categories. The first is autocrine signaling. In what happened in the autocrine signaling, the target cell will act on the same type of the cell which is surrounding itself. Like if this is a like skin cell, we can say these all are a same type of cell. What it will do, it will generate a signal for, it will generate a signal molecule like the red in color to these cell, so they can respond accordingly. So here we can see the target the cell itself. Sometime autocrine cell can target cell close by itself or of same type. So in autocrine also the signal molecule is released by the same cell and it will generate the, it will bind to the receptor on the present on the same cell and it will respond. So it is for the same cell or same type of the cell which is very near to. Next is paracrine signaling, target signaling. In this the target cell is in the vicinity of emitting, for the emitting cell. If it is the best example of this is the neurotransmitter in which a neuron will generate a signal molecule to the next neuron. Next is the endocrine signaling. In this the best example is the hormones. You know hormones have very various hormones have different function for the like various biochemical processes and it travel through the blood. So in this the signal is released by the gland and it will transfer, it will transport it to the different sites with the help of, it will released into the blood and from blood it is to the target cell. It will bind to the target cell and respond accordingly. The next is the ejectocrine signaling. What happened in the ejectocrine signaling? It is target adjacent or touching cell. It is more like autocrine cell, but in autocrine we have a same type of cell, but in this the cell can be different. These signals are transmitted along the cell membrane via protein or lipid component integral to the membrane. So in the last slide we learned about this plasma membrane molecule. It is the example of ejectocrine only. So the when the signal molecule bind to the receptor, it will affect the cell. So it is affecting either the emitting cell or the cell immediately adjacent. So the next slide is of the ligand and the receptor. So receptors and the ligands are come in many form, like in the form of protein, in the form of hormone, or in the form of like some chemicals, but they have one thing in common. They come in closely matched pair with a receptor recognizing just one or specific ligand and a ligand binding to just one receptor. So it is like a lock and key model. So here if this is a ligand, this is circular form, so it will reside in this circular part of the receptor. So if the ligand is of triangular form, so we have the receptor like this, which have a notch like this, so this triangular form will fit into this. So it is some like enzyme substrate lock and key model in the form. So this receptor will again produce some changes, conformational changes, and this will affect the different molecules. So binding of ligand to the receptor change its shape and activity. So what happen, like if this is our receptor and signal molecule bind here, so after binding there is, this is receptor and this is signal molecule. So after binding the receptor will change its shape or configuration, like it will be like become like this. So this will cause the change and this change will lead to the further signaling inside the cell, which is called intramolecular intracellular signaling, and cell will respond accordingly. So there are two type of receptor. The first is the intracellular receptor and second is the cell surface receptor for the ligands. Though the as the name suggests, intracellular receptor, these are found inside the cell, and the second one is the cell surface receptor, which is found on the plasma membrane of the cell. So let it be this bill like if this is a cell, and you know the cell have gaps, cell membrane have a gaps. So some molecules are so small that some signal molecule are so small, so they can cross this membrane and act, and they can act, and these signal molecule have the receptor inside the cell. So receptor is like this, it is present inside the cell, and signal molecule will go and bind here. This type of receptors are called intracellular receptor, but generally the receptor are present on the cell membrane. So these type of receptors are called cell surface receptor, which is present on the cell membrane. So the we go into the detail of the intracellular receptors. So intracellular receptors are receptor proteins found on inside the cell, typically in the cytoplasm or the nucleus. The second is the ligand of the intracellular receptor are small. Why they are small? Because they have to cross the cell membrane, and the cell membrane pore size is that size is very small. So they must able to cross the membrane to further start the signaling process or to bind the ligand. So membrane in order to reach their receptor. In this, the best example is the hydrophobic steroids hormone, such as sex hormones. So this is steroid. Example is estrogen and testosterone, and these molecule will cross the cell membrane and will act on the receptor present inside the cytoplasm. So the next is when a hormone enters and a cell, it bind to its specific receptor, and when the ligand will bind to the receptor, it will cause the conformational changes in that receptor, and it will now what happen, it will regulate the activity of the gene. So how will it control the activity of the gene? So what happen when a hormone binds, in case of testosterone, hormone bind with the receptor, it will change the configuration of the receptor, because the receptor is also protein. So when the ligand will bind, it will cause the change in the shape of the receptor, and it will expose the DNA binding site of the receptor. Now the receptor can easily bind to the DNA. So like this, we can say if this is the receptor and this is the signal molecule binds, and this is the binding site, this is the DNA binding site. So when signal molecule will bind to this receptor, it will change its configuration. So it will expose this binding site. Now this receptor can easily bind to the DNA. Now this receptor can easily bind to the DNA, and it will bind on the promoter site and start the specific function of that gene. So, it can alert the level of transcription. So, in this we can see this is the extracellular fluid and this is the plasma membrane. The signal molecule will cross the cell membrane, and in cytoplasm the intracellular receptor is present which will bind to the signal molecule, and this signal molecule will, what it will do? It will cause the conformational changes in this receptor, and this receptor bind to the DNA and will start some transcriptional activity like formation of messenger RNA, which can lead to the formation of the various enzymes or biomolecules for the functioning of the cell which is required. So, next is the cell surface receptor. Cell surface receptor are the membrane encode protein that bind to the ligand on outside the surface of the cell. So, I have already discussed this. If this is the cell, these are the receptor. So, it is present on the cell membrane. As we know, the cell membrane is contain the two part, the outer membrane and the inner membrane, and the in between that it is intramembrane space. This is the space. So, this type of receptor contain three part. First the extracellular part. So, this extracellular part, it's come out from the membrane and it has a site for the signal molecule. It has a site for signal molecule. The next is hydrophobic domain extended through the membrane. So, this is the hydrophobic domain. Next is the intracellular domain, which is present inside the cell. So, this part is present, this is the intracellular domain. So, what happened when the signal molecule will bind, it will transfer this signal molecule and transfer the signal and cause a conformational change in this receptor, and this receptor will again pass this conformational change activity to the next signal receptors or the effector proteins which is present in the cell membrane, for example like G proteins, and it will start the activity. So, in this type of signaling, the ligand does not need to the cross the membrane, because they are very like they have large size. So, they cannot cross the membrane, and their receptor are present on the cell membrane itself. So, many different kind of molecule like large hydrophobic or water loving one may act as a ligand in this type of cases. So, thank you. This is all about the cell signaling, and in next future slide we will go into the details of G protein signaling, apoptosis, etcetera. Thank you. You can contact me on this ID deepakgola@gmail.com.